Please tell me again where we are going.
I found a letter from the Prince Consort among Lucy Thorne's research, marked with the same insignia as your key, dated 1847.
1847?
The same year the Prince began renovations to Buckingham Palace.
You think he added a vault for the Shroud?
And since there is no map of the palace with the room marked Secret Vault...
Your Highness, may I present Miss Evie Fry. Miss Fry, Maharaja Duleep Singh.
A pleasure, Your Highness.
My friend, the plans you asked for have been removed.
Removed? By whom?
Crawford Starrick, or someone employed by him. Yes, I thought you might recognize the name. I know where they are, but it is heavily guarded.
That part will not be a problem.
I thought not.
We're going to need a plan.
I can provide a distraction for the guards while you find a safe way inside.
Oh, really?
For you, Evie? Certainly.
Well, once I'm inside, I'll find someone who knows where the papers are stored.
And we will meet back on the train.
Be careful. What's the plan?
When you give the signal, I'll draw the guards into a fight and then use a smoke bomb to get away.
And I'll take advantage of the confusion. Ready?
Absolutely.
That's not them. Thank you. here. No. Looks like I have to ask someone where the plans are.
I don't know where they've taken him.
Taken who?
The man, dressed like you. The guards dragged him off.
Henry, the plans you stole, where are they?
I don't know anything about that.
The plans. The mission. You're some of Clara's children.
They took Mr. Henry. We couldn't stop them.
I bit one of them good, though.
They dragged him off in a red carriage.
They won't get far, though. One wheel looked like it was about ready to fall off. You can see the cart tracks. It looks so wobbly-like.
Driving quickly. Come on!
They're knocking people over, too. And destruction of public property. I must be on the right track.
Look out! Come on!
That must be the carriage. Found you. Now to find Henry.
Happenings around here today. All kinds of unsavory types wandering around, armed to the teeth. I don't like it one bit.
Beef and stewing for all appetites, for all means, for God's sake.
Body.
I found you. What do I get? Is she hiding from the coppers?
She's gone.
She's hiding. Why is she hiding?
Oh. Why in hell's name?
I saw them dragging someone out of the carriage after the wheel fell off. They said he'd hit his head. Not sure why they needed to take him to the church, but that's where they went.
She's hiding.
You, madam. Try Ambrosia, then.
Killing an assassin will move me up in the world.
Where did she go? Do you need assistance?
That's an intruder!
Yes, they pulled someone out of that carriage. Dead drunk he was. They carried him into the churchyard. Maybe he wanted a quiet place to sleep it off.
Hope she's not doing it.
She's an intruder!
Oh, yes.
this gate? This is supposed to be locked. Bloody urchins opened it again, no doubt.
Send someone to move the architectural plans. Do you have them?
Did they hurt you?
I'm fine.
Let's go.
What about the plans?
The plans are lost.
Evie, I'm sorry.
Just concentrate on escaping, please. Get Miss Nightingale to look at that. I must find the vault before Starrick secures the shroud.
We'll talk to the Maharaja again.
I will talk to the Maharaja. You will get your head looked at.
I'm sorry my capture hasn't done your plans.
You'd be safer on the train.
Even if you find the vault, you can't just walk into Buckingham Palace alone.
I won't be alone. I'll see you back at the train, Mr. Green.
Oh,
you won't know what it...
Maybe tell
him. I don't want to die!
Just stop.
Don't break it anywhere. Please,
please, don't kill me. Cutest thing I've ever seen.
I wonder what all the argy bargy's about.
Lucky I'm trying to keep up with you.
Everything I've ever done was for the Order. And now they're pretending I don't exist.
Of course, as soon as I get into trouble, they stop supporting me.
Where would they be if they didn't have me cleaning up their messes? In the ground, that's where.
I better see what that is.
And it'll be your last.
What's this then? You a cop or something?
Quiet down, Mr. Linton. Hush now.
A lady? I've never fought a lady before. You are here to fight me, are you not?
I'm here to take you to the police.
Let me go. Let's have a real tussle, shall we? Turn around and put up your fists. Come on.
Sure. If you'd just come with me first. Where were we?
Hey! Let me out of here! I didn't agree to this!
Move it! Slowly now.
Best be going before he's sick in the carriage.
There you are. Faster! Come on! Easy now. Come on! Yeah! Move it! Easy, girl. Come on! Come on!
Come on! slow.
I need some help here. Too slow. I need some help here. Beg pardon? Unhand me, rascal. I said let me go.
Keep your voice down. Quiet, Mr. Harley.
Who sent you, woman? Beg pardon? Beg pardon? Help! I'm trapped! Someone help me!
Faster! Easy.
Something out of a nightmare, that one.
All right, B. Who are you and what's your game? Stir up some trouble.
I've been seeing adverts for this show called this the Trickster. Might be a lark.
All together now.
From our own lines, was it? Now, a lesser commander
Well, if it isn't my dear old chum, Mr. Disraeli. Now, Prime Minister, which of your friends is about to stab you in the back?
The Corrupt Practices Bill is a vital step in reforming our government. If the majority party is allowed to dictate the results of contested elections, we can scarcely call ourselves free.
If we yield up our rights bit by bit to the courts, we can scarcely call ourselves free, sir.
This is so like you, Gladstone.
Coppers must be
out. You would rather throw your body upon the gears of progress than surrender one iota of power.
By God, Disraeli, you are a fool. I'll not stand idly by and watch you drag parliamentary privilege through the muck.
No, certainly not. You'd rather return us to the yoke of tyranny? Perhaps while we're at it, Mr. Gladstone, we could repeal Magna Carta and return the crown to the bloody Stuarts!
How dare you, sir?
I'm certain it would provide a...
Merely because I do not wish to see government placed in the hands of judges, you would make these slanderous accusations? I'll not stand for it!
Then I shall obviate the requirement. Good evening, sir.
I presume. Pleasure to meet you. B,
my name's Herbert.
Then why are you following the Prime Minister?
It's just the job, sir! Some old bloke paid me to...
Smug bastard. Well, I was born in Crawley, but that's by the by. Who are you working for?
I never got his name. Old chap, big moustache, wore some kind of uniform. Who's ours, maybe?
What's his game?
Please, you'll kill me.
And a three-story drop will shatter your legs and send you to the workhouse. Difference is, you can run from him.
Tomorrow! My lads are going to attack the Prime Minister's carriage on the way to Parliament.
Perfect.
I surrender. I'm sorry I got in your way. Please, let me go.
Thank you.
There! You can hide up there!
Shot right off!
Take
me! Put your tongue out!
Look sharp. I will be back.
Thanks. What do you suppose she's doing? Trust me. Thanks for the help, lady. Hide and seek? So childish.
I ought to write a book on the oddities of the human behavior.
be doing this much longer.
Thanks for watching, miss.
So much for the house call. I have to find a way into that carriage.
Of this. Who the devil are you?
Prime Minister, I'm your new bodyguard, Jacob Fry.
I wasn't informed of any new bodyguard. Who's your commanding officer?
Let the boy speak, Dizzy.
Madam, apologies. But we've learned of a threat on your life. And the Met thought it best to move quickly.
Threat? What sort of threat?
That sort. If you excuse me a moment.
Come on.
here. What's all this?
Not so fast, Your Excellency.
About Gladstone, young man.
I assure you, madam, Gladstone is innocent in this.
But he tried to kill my husband.
Well, we'll look into Gladstone. Perhaps you can help me with another inquiry, madam. A gentleman with ties to Parliament, older, wears cavalry uniforms and has a large mustache.
You seem like a rough and ready sort of fellow, Mr. Fry.
Well, yes, I am, actually.
And are you familiar with the poorer districts of our city?
Roughly.
Wonderful. As it happens, I've been eager to tour the Devil's Acre. If you were to escort me, I'd be happy to assist you in your inquiry.
That strikes me as a dangerous idea.
Then it's settled. Come back here to Downing Street tomorrow night, 8 o'clock sharp. Good day, Mr. Fry.
But I...
Good day!